Hi, my name's Ian Van Tile, and behind me is a 2012 Jeannot 379 Sun Odyssey that is new to the market here in Southern California. The vessel's located at Fiddler's Cove in Coronado Island. So let me give you a little tour about this vessel, and if you have any questions or would like to go and schedule an appointment to see this vessel, please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. So let me show you a little.
So as you can see here, this is a beautiful 2012 Jeannot 379 Sun Odyssey. The vessel has a really unique lines on it, from its injected molded deck to its Mark Lombard design hull. The vessel also possesses a really nice double bow roller up here. We have a tang right here for a dedicated tack line if you're flying an asymmetrical or symmetrical spinnaker, second bow roller, and a really nice Facnor jib furling system. The Mark Lombard design hull is very stable, a very solid, well-performing vessel. In big wind conditions, you're going to feel a very light helm, and it's going to be very well balanced. Also notice that we have inboard shrouds. That allows us to have a much larger head sail than most boats with outboard shrouds, and also distributes the weight evenly throughout the center pan of the vessel and the whole construction, integrating it with its keel. As we come aboard the vessel, you're going to see that we have a really nice dodger here. The dodger is a taupe dodger with a kind of a burnt orange piping. It is quite gorgeous. It matches out really well. We have a really large Harken traveler here, giving you really good control over the mainsail. The main is a classic mainsail here with the stack pack that matches all of the canvas on the boat. So it's quite beautiful and really possesses a great ease of handling when dropping it down into the bag and then zipping the cover up when you're finished. There's also steps on the mast that allow you to easily do that as well. On the foredeck is quite large and flat. We have a really nice large anchor locker here. The locker is a quick windlass. There's a wash down here for the anchor. It looks like we have all chain on the vessel. Notice that we have really nice cleats here. The tow rail is a composite tow rail, so there's zero maintenance on that tow rail, which is really nice. All of the halyards and sheets lead to these organizers, leading back into the cockpit. Notice that we have really nice flush mount, Lumar hatches, and really high-end running rigging on this. As we come back, you're gonna see we have the dodger, the connector that removes, and then it goes into our bimini. The bimini has two really nice windows that allow you to have great visibility when underway. As we come into the cockpit, you're gonna see we have a nice cockpit table here with great stainless steel grab handles. We have the dual helms. The Mark Lombard design is very wide and beamy, but not over excessive beamy, which creates an additional wetted surface area. So it allows you to have a single rudder, but yet possess a really nice hard shine on the transom. At the starboard helm, we're going to have our autopilot and then our tri-data with oversized Harken winches. We have our throttle control and then our engine instrument panel located below that. We also have our VHF RAM mic that's hardwired, so we have full control of our VHF here at the helm. Just centrally below my feet here, this is a dedicated life raft or storage locker. Then we have our access to our emergency tiller. Centrally located is obviously the cockpit table with the new E90 wide Raymarine plotter. The port helm itself has a multi-function repeater, and then once again, really nice, beautiful cockpit cushions that finish this out really well. We have a large locker underneath this port bench here, and possesses lots of storage and then access to the companionway storage as well too. We have a Harken winch up to the port side. And then on the starboard side, for the items that aren't really used often, we have a pulley that leads over to this winch if you need to. But pretty much everything on this side is pretty much stationary in a sense, and all of your working loads are onto the port. As we come down below, we have the galley off to the starboard side. We have a two burner stove and oven. Just above that, a microwave, lots of cabinet storage throughout, a very deep refrigerator, double stainless sinks here, nice European style faucet with a backsplash. And once again, tons of storage. They really integrated lots of storage into this.
directly across from the galley is our nav station. We also have a really nice hanging locker here for foul weather gear. There is a drip drain on the bottom of this. We have our 12 volt and 110 electrical panel, the Simrad docking station, so if you have an iPod or iPhone, and then your Fusion stereo controls. This is also operated by the Raymarine up in the cockpit. The lower VHF Standard Horizon Explorer unit, so really nice VHF here. And then in front of this, we have our inverter and air conditioning sub-panel. We have the Cruise air conditioning. Right now it's on dehumidify mode, so it's keeping the vessel really nice and dry. We have the Xantrax battery monitor system, and then the inverter charger. This is a really nice upgraded inverter charger. We have 12 volt found throughout the vessel. Really nice side ports with aviation style shades here. So this is a really nice touch here. Lots of cabinetry and storage and a really large salon. This is the ultra leather. It's kind of like an off cream white ultra leather. This is the luxury salon table. So you have leaves on both sides. And then also you have a filler cushion area where this area folds up and creates a really nice platform. A filler cushion goes right into this. So it creates a really nice lounging area or another bunk. A very large JVC flat screen television found up on the forward bulkhead. Up in the forward master, we have a great stateroom up here. We have a great storage. As you can see, we have our another air conditioning outlet up here. You know, storage up all around this, and another hanging locker on this backside. Once again, 12 volt fans found everywhere. And as we come back aft, you'll have a really nice view of the salon here. All of the overhead lighting is all LED, so really nice and efficient there. And then as we walk aft, we're going to see the aft stateroom. The aft stateroom is quite large. This is a queen size berth back here. We have two opening hatches and then two side ports, one with an aviation shade and another one with an ocean air shade that just comes over here. Another air conditioning port here, a 12 volt fan, and then a full hanging locker. So directly across from the galley, just aft of it a little bit, is our head and shower. This is a great head and shower here. We have a nice stainless steel bowl sink, mirror, storage cabinetry below and above, and then we have a electric Jabsco quiet flush toilet, which is just push of a button. And then as we go straight through this, we have a very large aft storage locker. This area possesses lots of room for all your storage tools and what have you. Then you also have a separate shower. The shower door itself will close and encompass the whole shower area. We have a really nice high-end fixture with wand type spouts. Once again, overhead opening hatch, lots of shades and screens found throughout.
So I hope you found this video walkthrough to be helpful and informative. If you have any questions or would like to come down and check out this vessel in person, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. You can reach me on my cell phone number, is 619-507-4416. Thanks again, and I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.